and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a blue look for you because I felt like using a blue makeup palette. Then you're going to end up with a blue eye look. Logic. Anyway. Today turned into a bit of a chatty video, so I'm afraid. Not really afraid, really. I like long videos personally too, so I think this video is probably going to be pretty long. So I would advise you to grab a drink and grab a snack, and then let's get started. Okay, as usual, we're just gonna start out with the eye primer. I've already done my eyebrow just because this is going to be more of a chatty type of video, and I know myself, and if I don't do my eyebrows first, then... Well, let's just say that this video is going to be long anyway, and my eyebrows on average take me about 12 hours, so yeah. I am just tidying them a little bit with the eye primer. I haven't done this method in a while, like lately I've been doing my eyebrows lost. But I figured I just turned it around again to see if I like this better now or if my preferences are still switched, and yeah. Starting off with a sort of cool taupe shade in the crease just to deepen it up, and also the outer corner with a big fluffy brush. Using the Blue Blood Palette by Jeffree Star today. Simply because I used it like yesterday. I was doing makeup for photoshoots and I used this on two models, so yeah. I don't know, like I have enough stuff in my makeup kit, obviously my professional kit, that I can do any look I want. That's quite important to have, of course. But I also at the same time quite enjoy it to bring, you know, my own palettes, like from my own personal makeup stash, along on shoots every now and then to use them on other people, just because they are palettes that I actually love. Palettes. Never sure how to pronounce it. But they are ones that I do love to use, so I want to use them on other people too. And yeah, yesterday I decided to bring the Blue Blood Palette and my brushes lost in hair. Anyway, and two of the models ended up wearing a blue dress, so it actually turned out quite perfect that I actually had this palette with me. Now it's time to add some blue. I'm going for an average middle blue with a slightly smaller brush. Basically, I'm just doing the whole steps of going smaller with each color and darker with each color. Or in this case, mostly brighter. Point being, you can see what I'm doing. Anyway, also more kind of exciting news. Well, I guess if you enjoy watching sort of makeup reviews for me, then it might be exciting. Because as everyone probably knows who's interested in makeup, there's a new Jeffree Star Cosmetics palette, the collab with Jane Dawson. Which is really, really cool. Like, I obviously watched the entire series and I immediately was like, okay, I need to have that palette. And yeah, as probably also everyone knows, the entire internet, like every single website that sold it, crashed that evening. But through one Dutch website, like at first, when it started to like get laggy and all, I immediately blamed my Wi-Fi, because I always immediately blame my own Wi-Fi. That's just a fact of life. My own Wi-Fi is, well, it's okay to feel sorry for my Wi-Fi, because it gets a lot of shit. Like, whenever something goes wrong, I immediately blame the Wi-Fi. Then I realized, okay, other websites are working just fine. So I figured, okay, maybe it's just the website that I was trying to order from, which is a Dutch makeup web shop, the Makeup Spot to be precise. Well, then I checked Beauty Bay and they were lagging too, so I figured, a lot of people apparently want this palette. So I just kept refreshing the page until it finally sent me through to the actual payment page. And then I could finally complete the order. So I ordered the palette. It's probably going to arrive by the time you're seeing this video, because it will arrive somewhere around halfway through November. I seriously have to think which month it is now. But yeah, so I'm definitely not really going to do a review, because by the time I get it, a lot of people will already have it, obviously, and have already done reviews. But I do want to do a couple of looks just with that palette. Just really try it out, play with it, and just, you know, share my thoughts on it. I expect to like the palette, because so far I've liked all of his palettes, so yeah. Now I'm just adding a bolder, darker blue in the outer V. Well, more sort of making an outer C out of it, really. Point being, just to deepen it up a little. And as always, by the way, if you don't have this palette, you can, of course, just use like this one. You can always just use something else, like for a blue eye look, I would advise to use a blue eyeshadow. But other than that, like, you don't need to use the exact same products as I did. Anything I did use, by the way, will be below in the video description as always, in case you want to know. And yeah, I actually quite like doing blue looks on myself, and I really don't feel like I do it often enough, simply because... I always feel when I do a blue look, I really need to make like a full look of it and really make everything work and fit together. Just because if I just slap on, like I can just slap on bronzy shades, orange shades, stuff like that, and just call it a day and it'll be fine. With a blue look, I really need to make it pretty. Like I need to make an effort at it, just because blue by nature just doesn't look right on me. Like basically, I really need to make like a full look. I hope you get what I mean. But if I just put blue on my eyelid and blend it out and call it a day and not add a lot of other makeup on the rest of my face, it's just going to look as if I haven't slept in like 5 weeks. Because it just clashes with my skin tones. But yeah, nevertheless, I do actually like how it clashes, just because it does actually stand out, so I'm trying to use it more. Then it's time to use a matte highlight shade to create a matte brow bone highlight. Then I'm just grabbing my big fluffy blender again without any extra product on it, just to make sure that the brow bone highlight and the crease shades are going to blend together nicely. Now I want to do something I don't do often. No, not poking myself in the eye with a brush. But this little bit of darkness here, I'm going to use the tinier fluffy blender for that. I really think it was called something like Fluffy Blender. It's an actual beauty brush, I mean. But the name faded off completely, so I can't tell you. But anyway, I'm just going to try to get it symmetrical and just pretty much place a tiny little thick line. Right by the inner corner. A little bit above it, of course. Just to sort of get a bit of a shadow there as well. I don't know, like I just feel like it adds a little bit more dimension. And again, it's something I don't really do often, but I've seen a lot of people do it on Instagram lately. I remember doing it as well at some point in time, but I kind of just stopped doing that, so yeah. Time to try it again, and I am going to pack this on first. I'm going to use the paler blue shade, the bright blue that I used second on the crease. And just blend this out. And I'm mostly going to blend it out to the sides and the bottom. And I want to keep the top part kind of sharp, just so you get this almost lined effect. I don't know, I think it looks kind of like designer and cool. And I'm going to only use this brush for it, because I feel if I use the bigger brush, then it's just going to be, I don't know, to blend it out and won't really pack the punch anymore than it does when it's like really precise. Then it's time to finish up the eyelid. I'm going to start off with a blue shade, sort of a middle blue shade, but then with shimmer. On a sort of fluffy-ish eyeshadow brush. I do want it to be, you know, packed on. I do want the shimmer to show, but I don't want to do like a cut crease effect. I wanted to keep it all soft and smoky this time around. So I'm basically just packing it onto the center and the outer edge, already blending it together with the matte shade a little bit. And then for the inner corner, I'm just going to use the same brush, barely wiping it off, and just use a very pale whitish shade. And I'm going to put it all the way up to where the little patch of darkness here in the inner corner is. Just to make sure everything goes nicely together. And then it's back to the tiny fluffy blender for a moment. And just blend the edges of that, so everything goes nice and smooth. And there's no like harsh lines between the matte and the shimmer. Now we're going to complete the look like this. I'm going to use a very tiny eyeshadow brush for that. And the darkest blue from this palette, which is basically a very dark blue. I really can't describe it anyway else. Yeah, I'm just going to apply that carefully in a thin line across this dark patch here. And then pretty much just pull it downwards a little bit by means of blending. I'm not going to use any other brush to blend this, because I don't want it to be too much, and I do want it to be sort of like a stripe, so we get this result. So kind of blend it downwards, but not blend it upwards. Just so it all stays nice and sharp. And then for the outer corner, I'm going to do an eyeliner also with this eyeshadow, because I do want to keep it soft, but I don't know, like I just love cat eye shapes and I want to do one even when I don't want to use an actual eyeliner for it. So I'm just basically very carefully applying this. I'm trying to not get too much fallout. Always a risk with a tiny brush, because you're really stabbing it into the eyeshadow. And I'm going to blend it into my lashes pretty much. I'm going to use it as an eyeliner till about halfway on the top lid. Making sure the wing is dark enough too. And of course, if you're like me doing this before you're doing your face base, then fallout isn't really important. And you can still actually change the shape of the liner if you don't like it enough. So that helps. But yeah, I'm just applying it and I'm blending it into my lashes to about halfway on my eyelid. Leaving the rest of the eyelid alone, and then I'm just going to go instantly to the inner corner. And just blend it into the lash line there as well. Which is a lot easier if you're not looking directly into the brush. Just so we get this result. Almost as an afterthought, but I'm just going to put the shimmery pale shades at the highest point of my brow bone as well. Because I feel like it looks more complete that way. So, I've got my face base done and already contoured one side of my face, except for my nose, I still need to do that. But anyway, we're gonna contour now. I'm using this Catrice product. And, well, it's warm toned and it even has a little bit of shimmer in it, so I'm like breaking like 5 million contouring rules right now. But I feel like, for one, the shimmer doesn't really show up all that much, so that's fine. And second, I feel for my colouring, it's better to use warm shades for bronzing and all, to use warm shades on my face when I use, a cool tone of eyeshadow. Just to sort of counter it, so it all becomes kind of like balanced. Because if I would go for cool shades on my face as well, then it would just look wrong on me. The orange hair helps too, actually, like, that's also a thing. But yeah, just kind of contour. And for blush, I'm just going to play it safe and use a very pale peachy shade. Basically a shade that will fit with anything and it's also pale enough that even if you would rub the entire thing over your face, it wouldn't be overpowering. It's a very safe option, basically. Then for highlight, I'm going to go for a silvery bluish tone and connect it to the brow a little bit. It's a nice shimmer. I'm also going to use this as a sort of top coat on my inner corners. Now it's time to finish up the eyeballs. I'm going to use the short, tiny little mini brush with the darkest shade to apply that to my outer corner. I don't know how I was planning on finishing that sentence. Anyway, I'm just putting it in my inner corner and outer corner and blending it towards my inner corner until right about here. Nothing too much. Then I'm going to use the tiny fluffy blender and dip it into the bold blue shade and the middle blue shade. And use that to blend everything out. Well, everything I just applied basically. I'm also pulling it into the inner corner just to make sure there's a little bit of hint, just a hint of blue right there as well. And just blend it until you're happy with how it fades into the skin. On my waterline I'm going to use blue. Admittedly this isn't the most pigmented pencil. It's by Essence and I actually completely forgot I had it in the first place. But yeah, they're cheap and they do actually work. They're just not very opaque, unfortunately. And then time for some mascara and then some falsies. So lips. Lips are next, but the eyelashes are on at this point. This is Illusion by XO Beauty. And yes, I know she actually also released a makeup palette. But for those of you who watch my videos regularly, you already know that I recently drowned my old laptop, which really wasn't meant to be broken yet, in coffee. So financially, it was smarter to make decisions in terms of what makeup to buy. So I only bought the new Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson palette and, you know, I still want the XO Beauty palette too, but that's just something that's going to have to wait until like next month or so. Yeah. Anyway, for the lips I'm going to go with a red shade just because, I don't know, I want a little bit more warmth in my face, so yeah. Then as usual, some sanding spray and we're done. And we're left with the final results. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel. Although I suppose you can also watch them without subscribing, but still, you know. There are mostly makeup tutorials, very surprising. For now at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!